Hello, everybody. I'm so excited about this. I'm trying to wait for Facebook Live to pop on really quickly. But guys, I'm so excited to introduce amazing Mooveguru and then Denise from Kai's companies. And of course, one of their top producers in all of Florida. I'm so excited, you guys. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Can you guys hear me all right? Are we all on the same page?
Yes.
Can we? Awesome. Okay, cool. So I'm just going to dive into this, if you don't mind. Are we ready for this?
Yep.
Sounds great.
Awesome. Okay, so first and foremost, thank you to all our attendees for showing up and, you know, really, really learning from what we offer here at LabCoat. And of course, today we're talking about all about referrals and relocation. And of course, we're end of the year, so I'm ready for this. And I know most of us, and especially me, I'm very interested in, you know, this amazing service and amazing company that Scott has built and created, which is Mooveguru. Oh my gosh, welcome, Scott. And I'd love for you to tell us more about Mooveguru, but more than anything, Denise is an amazing relocation specialist, I believe, in, you know, all of, I think, Fort Lauderdale, right, Denise?
One of the many markets we cover, yes.
Yeah, and you're with the Kai's company, VP of Global Relocation and Corporate Services for the Kai's company, a family of companies, which I'm just so excited to hear more about. And then she's got her top producer of the entire companies of Kai's, that is Mikey, and I'm told that I can use that name. But Mike Figueres, welcome everyone. Amazing to have everyone on board. So, you know, Denise, tell us more. And, you know, Scott, please talk to us more about this free service that you've got going.
Sure.
Go ahead, Scott.
Okay, yeah, I'll do a little bit of an introduction. I'll hand it over to you, Denise.
So yes.
We have a really interesting past with Kai's company because in all their other brands like Illustrated Properties and all the other companies that are part of the Kai's family of companies. We have been working with Kai's for almost 2 years. And the first year was just prep work. And it was just, okay, we're going to roll out this Mooveguru program, but really, how are we going to train the agents so that, I mean, how many agents do you have, Denise? 4,500 within the family?
Wow.
Yeah, let's go more like 3,500.
3,500, okay.
It's still a lot.
All I know is it's a lot. Yeah,
wow.
So there's a lot of agents to train. You know, there's a lot of questions to answer. We take referrals and relocation and leads, and we pass those back to Kai's company. So there was a lot to do. So for 2 years, the first part of that, the first year, we just planned and prepped. And then we've now been live with Kai's for over a year. We did just launch into one of their sister companies, Illustrated Properties, which is in the Orlando area. And it's just been a fantastic partnership. I mean, the
wow.
Kai's company are rock stars, and then you kind of overlay or maybe underlay Mooveguru into that to help feed the agent and do a whole bunch of automated things on the back end. It's just a really nice partnership. So Denise, I'm gonna pass it over to you, let you talk a little bit about Kai's, and we'll talk about Mooveguru later.
Denise, before you jump on, I definitely want to welcome again our audience because I think we were not on Facebook Live when I did welcome them. So I do want to welcome everybody. Please let us know in the chat where you're from. I'd love to know where everybody's from. We've got quite a few people here. So please do tell us where you're from. So we have Denise from Sacramento. We have someone from Boston. Anyone international joining us from Redondo Beach? Wow, we've got Scottsdale. We've got some fantastic people here on board. So, you know, we're so excited to share, you know, all this information. So get ready to really take your business to the next level. So Denise, sorry about that interjection. So go for it. Go.
So my name again is Denise Talboy. I head up the referrals, corporate services, and relocation division at the Kai's company, the Kai's family of companies. We have about 3,500 agents. And under different brands, right? So I'll only correct Scott a little bit. We don't cover Orlando, but Illustrated Properties is in Palm Beach County, and also a little bit of Martin County, and up to Port St. Lucie. the Kai's company per se manages Homestead, which is north of the Keys, and we have offices as north of Daytona.
I'm so excited. I'd love to be on your part of the woods. I'm looking forward to it.
It is still very hot, okay?
Wow.
And it's what? Down to November.
Wow.
We are one of the founding members of the Leading Real Estate Companies of the World Network. We are independently owned by the Pappas family. Again, we're the largest independent in the state of Florida. And because of our size, we do have a full IT department, marketing department, and obviously referrals division that constantly is looking at different tools. We provide an enormous amount of tools for all our agents. Mooveguru is one of them, which I think is one of the best tools we have, simply because it creates customers for life. If you haven't talked to them yet, you should. And we see that our agents, not only are they engaged with the program, but it also is a program that keeps past customers in contact with their agents. So you definitely want to look at that.
And that's so important because, you know, keeping in touch, we tend to forget as realtors in our business, and I'm sure Mikey will agree to this, is we tend to forget our past clients sometimes. I mean, we just were so go, focused on the new clients and relationships that we're looking to build, that we tend to kind of sort of put our past clients in the back burner. So this would be perfect. And I'd love to hear how, you know, Mikey is using it as a top producer in his area. I am so interested in learning how you do it. I know that you're a team leader for Spouses Sell Houses, and you know, that's real. I'm eager to learn from you as well, Mikey, and of course, know more about Mooveguru. But Denise, tell us a little bit about, you know, the importance, just if you can, just expand into the importance of referrals, how to handle them in order to be successful. I mean, I think that's a great question for Mikey as well, but I think that it would help us understand from your point of view as well.
I don't think anything that we're going to talk about today is but what I will say is that it is so critical for everyone on this call that when they're talking to other realtors, talking to customers, they always have to think beyond that one transaction.
Exactly.
I was trained in the hotel business eons ago. Yes, I started at 10. And basically the customer's always right, even if they're not, right? So you know, you have to respond quickly. You have to email back quickly, even if you don't have an answer. And again, it doesn't seem like rocket science, but to me, I mean, top producers like Mikey are the ones that understand that. And he can talk about how he manages referrals and relationships in his day-to-day local business. But mine is more of a macro type of relationship where we not only have referral programs for our agents, but we also create business opportunities and programs where they can also take advantage of them to generate their own business through their sphere of influence. So at any point, whether it's we give them or they generate themselves, it is critical that response time to the customer and also to the realtor that gave you that lead is so important. Right. Because if I'm going to trust you with a piece of business, well, I'm kind of want to know what's going on with it, right? So communication is really number one for all of us.
So Denise, I want to put it right back onto Scott right now. Scott, tell us a little bit about Mooveguru. Tell us how you were introduced in the Kai's companies, you know, and tell us a little bit about what Mooveguru is about, because I'm really curious. I know a lot of people that are watching, a lot of our realtors that are watching us might have not seen your first video that you did or your first, YouTube video that we have out there for you, but I did, and I was so impressed, but I want to know more.
Yeah. Thanks, Janky. And I'll just give you a real high level. So as I said, we support Kai's and we support 1,000 other brokerages across the country. And we support it in three different ways that all ties into our topic today, which is relocation and referrals. And I'm sure Mikey's going to have quite a bit to talk about on this. So real quick, we support the real estate community in three ways, and all three ways that we do it and I'm pausing for a dramatic effect, or all three.
Yay! Okay. No, let me do a drum roll real quickly. Woo! Let's go! Woo! That's what I am so impressed about. Like, free.
I mean, who doesn't want
free service? Talk to us.
I do presentations like this all the time, and people are like, oh, come on. It's not free. Don't tell me. Nothing's free. But so here's what we do. Okay, real quick. When you have a moving consumer, you've gone under contract with a buyer and a seller, we access your data flow through many different types of back-end systems like DocuSign, Dotloop, SkySlow, ProfitPower, and you name it, all these different companies. So then we start communicating with the customer by email and phone, but it looks like it's coming from the real estate agent. So it looks like the real estate agent, like Mikey, is sending an email to his customer saying, hey guys, I know moving's expensive and you're spending a lot of money. Here's a 15% coupon from the Home Depot up to $2,000. Maybe I can save you a couple $100. Sincerely, your agent.
And that's what I was impressed about, because it's coming from a top producer. Sorry to cut you off, but that is so impressive because it's coming from Mikey. That's amazing. Wow.
It looks like it's coming from Mikey. Mikey doesn't actually have to do anything.
Right.
Yeah. And then we do that. We also connect utilities. So we call up Mikey's customer and we say, hey, my name is Scott. I'm calling on behalf of Mikey from Kai's. And we're here to help you connect all of your utilities as a complimentary service brought to you by Mikey. Is now a good time, or should we schedule an appointment and call you back to connect all of your utilities? And people are like, really? You're going to help me connect all my utilities? Yeah, because we work with Mikey. And then finally, what Denise was talking about is we continue to touch all of your past customers every quarter with a different savings related to their home. And every quarter it's a different offer, but this goes ongoing. So 10 years from now, we're still going to be contacting Mikey's customers, looking like it's coming from Mikey, and it's going to have discounts surrounding their home. And every quarter, it's going to be another impression to his past customers, so that people like Denise and Mikey can get referrals and new business from your past customers.
Wow, that's amazing. But that's wow. Like, you know, that's half of our work that's already done to our past clients. But Denise,
you know why that's important, though? Because, yeah. I mean, every so often I get a call from a customer or an email from a customer saying, I loved my Kai's associate. I loved my illustrated agent, but I don't remember their name. So if you don't have a system in place while you're focusing on your day to day, that reminds them that you helped them 6 months ago, a year from now, then they're not going to remember. I mean, this is critical for that.
And Scott, this is a great tool too, because half the battle here of becoming a successful agent is a lot of us don't do what's most important, and that's the follow-up. Yep. And this is a great service that allows you to follow up.
Yeah.
It's a great way to do it, and it really is what success differentiates the successful agents to the rest of the pack, is that follow-up, and this is a great tool for it.
Hey, Mikey, yeah. Mikey, I have a question for you. So what percentage of your business do you think comes from referrals?
90%.
Oh, wow.
Yep.
Wow.
Wow.
This is from our clients.
Our success, and my wife and I, we preach this. We attribute all of our success to relationships. We've created relationships throughout the years, and those relationships lead to these referrals that we look for.
And you know, so many times I talk about how important it is to build these relationships, right? And you know, I want to know more from Mikey. I want to know, you know, let's have Denise talk about, you know, a little bit more about Mikey. Tell us more about Mikey, Denise.
Oh, geez. we were fortunate enough
Don't make me blush, Denise.
He's already blushing.
Enough to have Mike join us, him and his team, through an acquisition, actually. And what was it, maybe 5-6 years ago, Mike? It seems, I can't even remember how long it's been. And he can tell you a little bit about his business, but it has grown exponentially in the last 2 to 3 years. And he can talk about more on how he's done that and how he's maximized it.
Yep.
So yeah, Mikey, let me jump in. Let me jump in real quick, Mikey, and let me ask you a question, because I'm actually kind of blown away that you said 90% of your business comes from referrals. I think the average agent out there hopefully thinks that maybe 30 or 40% come from referrals. Hopefully you're saying 90. So you're doing something really, really well. So what do you attribute that 90% of your business comes from referrals? You said relationships, but really hone in a little bit. What are you doing differently that other people aren't?
So we first and foremost, thanks for having me here. Denise, you know, thank you for the invitation. Thank you for thinking of me for this. So my wife and I, we started the Spouses Sell Houses back in 2015. And year after year, we've become more and more successful. And all the agents that we have on our team, we try and pass down, you know, our experience and our knowledge and our kind of our secret sauce. To answer your question, Scott, we try and provide exceptional service and value to these customers. We just don't want to be an agent who takes a contract. You know, when we first meet these clients, we literally tell them, hey, listen, put your feet up. We got this. You need a plumber, you need a painter, you need a handyman. We partner with the professionals that can help you out here. So we provide tons of value, and we like to leave them what we like to call a wow experience.
It's all about the wow, right? Because you want to make sure they're impressed, and we're in the relationship business, right? So I think that is so, you know, right on target, especially in having Mooveguru as part of it. Tell us more about that. How has your business changed, Mikey?
So Denise, I think you touched on it earlier. When we enter into a client relationship, our goal, it's not just to close that deal. It's to earn their business for life. You know, we voice it. You know, I had a mentor coming out of college and my first sales job. He says, if you don't ask, you don't get. And we voice it, you know, we let them know, hey, listen, we're going to work hard for you. We're going to bust our tails for you. And we want to win your business for life, you know, and we go above and beyond. You know, we used to say there's 10 realtors on every corner. Now we say there's about 1,000. So we have to find a way to separate ourselves from the competition and Mooveguru. That, I mean, I think it's a great service, you know, and that it's just an extra tool for us to use.
And please talk about your year-end party, because that is a good source of leads as well.
Yeah, so every year what we like to do, we like to celebrate not only our success but the accomplishments that you know, all our clients that trusted us with, you know, the importance of this transaction gave us. And to give you an example, this last year, 2019, we invited everybody to a rooftop party at downtown Fort Lauderdale. You know, we had drinks, it was a nice cocktail, we got to dress up. But the purpose was, we invited everybody back that we've ever done business with, not just 2019, and we got to see them, we got to connect with them again. And it was just a nice way to, you know, have a drink and, you know, not talk so much business and celebrate everybody. It was nice. But yeah, that's one thing that we do to establish and grow these relationships.
Hey, Mikey, so we've been a partner with you for over a year. So I'm assuming my invitation to that rooftop party got lost.
It got lost.
Is that what happened? Because I didn't go.
Oh, my goodness.
Now he's blushing.
But those are the examples that, you know, you and for the agents that are on here now, relationships are what are going to make a long-term career here. And referrals is the livelihood of our business. It's the best compliment a client can give you. And those are things that we pass down to our agents. I'm sure we'll talk a little bit more about our team management, but we really try and pass those that experience and the importance of what relationships do for us in this industry. And it's not just relationships with clients, it's relationships with your broker, with colleagues. You know, my wife and I, you know, if we submit an offer to a listing agent, you know, chances are they know that client's being well represented, and we got a good chance of completing everybody's objective.
Yeah, and absolutely. I've read amazing letters from buyers, and this is a great idea, why they would be great in that home. especially in our market where we're seeing, competing bids or competing offers. I think Mikey shared one with me that was absolutely incredible. Why this couple that was moving into the area, why they want that home. And those are the things that we're doing much more of. And he can talk about that now because that got him the home.
Yep. No, it's great. I mean, in this competitive market, you really got to go above and beyond. And it's so important, with the realtors that your clients work with. I mean, it's you have to dress up these offers. And a letter like that, Denise, we have our letters, our clients, type letters and put a nice photo and dress up these offers, because it really is competitive down here in South Florida. I'm sure in California is just as competitive. Yeah.
I love that, by the way, Denise and Mike, because most people in the industry think, okay, it's a contract, it's a piece of paper, it's just black and white. And what you're really doing right there is you're putting the human touch to it.
No, it's people.
And you're making it not just about the piece of paper, you're making it about a family that's going to live their lives in that home. And that touches people on an emotional level. I love that.
Yeah.
So we have a quick question from Mallory here. She says, can we go back to the beginning? Where do the referrals and buyers or sellers come from? We know how to stay in touch and get existing client referrals. We understand relationships. New referrals not related to past clients is our concern. We want referrals from other states or locals to New York City. Can you help out here, Denise?
I'll talk a little bit about our membership in the leading real estate companies of the world network. They have a very organized program of what we call incoming and outgoing referrals. That is under my responsibility and my department's responsibility. But even if you're not within the network, you should be reaching out to realtors and like you're marketing, a specific neighborhood, you should also be, marketing other realtors. If you're in South Florida, a lot of our business now is coming from the Northeast. People want to get out and have a little bit more land, have bigger homes that they can, afford. We're getting a lot of inquiries from Chicago. So what should you be doing as a realtor? Connect with the areas that are your feeder markets. We, for example, can receive referrals from not only leading RE brokers, but non-leading RE brokers, which and those recommend others, and those recommend others because of how we handle the business. So think where your feeder markets are coming in. You can advertise through Facebook if you have listings. There's a way to advertise those listings in those specific markets through Facebook. And let me tell you, people think it doesn't work. It works because we have listings that are promoting it in specific markets, they're getting the leads for it. So and I think that if you're not focused on social media, if you're not active on social media, you're missing out, because that's where the leads are coming in. That's where the buyers are looking at first. We're seeing, an increase in internet leads coming into our website, coming in through Facebook. And you need to be visible. You need to be visible. And we support our agents with social media flyers when they, when they need to, they don't know what to post. No, maybe they don't know what to post. Some are more active than others. So we have flyers for them to create, not only coming to them, but mainly going out. So we have a huge outgoing referrals department where we send 100 leads a month out to different markets. And our agents actually are targeting their customers. And if they're going on listing presentations, they not only want to get that listing, they want to figure out where that customer is buying in another market. So it's more just a big picture on how to drum up referrals and support our agents with all the tools that we have, including Mooveguru. I'm a big fan of their product. So you should be, after this webinar, you should be contacting Scott or his team, he may be busy, and get more information on their program, because they have really been a huge value to our business and to our agents.
Yeah, I was just about to ask you more information about, how do you guys on social media, how do you support your agents, with your company? how do you support your realtors, you know, having social media as part of it? And I know that Mooveguru does a fantastic job staying in touch with referral side of the business as well. So how do you collaborate it together?
We have a ton of tools other than Mooveguru, and a lot of that links into our CRM. So, I mean, the core listing machine is also another tool that we have that allows the agents that we basically are driving articles for the agents and posting on their behalf, obviously with their permission. And the agent's not doing it. We're doing it for them. So we have a very strong and amazing marketing department that supports all our agents to get our agents engaged on social media.
Yeah, that's just amazing. So let's revert back to Mooveguru. I want to hear a little bit more from Scott. Scott, tell us a little bit more about, you know, how do you really, I heard that there was one example that you had set out there in the YouTube video that you had said that, you know, they ordered pizza for everybody and, you know, you were just taking care of, you know, all the utilities and all that good stuff that was in the back end. Tell us what more Mooveguru provides, because this is just amazing service.
Yeah, thanks, Janky. And I'm going to, I'll answer your question, then I'm going to tie it back into what Denise had said about referrals. So one part of our platform, as I said, we have three parts. We connect utilities, we keep engaged with past customers, but during the move process, the interesting thing is a study was done. Moving is the fourth most stressful life event in someone's life ever. Fourth. That's crazy. So Anyway, it's a really stressful time. And if we can help support the real estate agent to make it less stressful for that consumer, what we have found, and I'm talking about thousands of times, agents have reached out to us and said, oh my gosh, you sent to me that Home Depot coupon, or you sent to me a discount from Budget Truck. And then I sent it to my sister in North Carolina, or I sent it to my best friend in New York, and they used it, but then they ended up calling the realtor because now that realtor's information. So remember, if that email is forwarded, let's say that Mikey has a client and Mikey sends it, or we send it on behalf of Mikey with say a discount from Potts, and it goes to his client. His client knows that his sister also would like a discount from Potts. Great. Well, they send it. All of Mikey's information is down at the bottom. So it becomes now that when they forward these emails on, Mikey's sphere of influence is growing. And of course his referral base is growing because they're going to send it to their next door neighbor. They're going to send it to their sister. They're going to send it to whomever because it's a great deal. Everyone loves to save money. So
absolutely,
if we can do that for Mikey, and we can make Mikey's clients happy, and then we can make them so happy that they send information about Mikey and what he's doing to their friends and family, we just won. So, and Mooveguru does this on behalf of Kai's. We do it on behalf of Mikey. We do it on behalf of 1,000 other brokerages across the country. And again, we do it all for free.
Wow. That's Denise, we have a question for you from Deborah, I believe. She's saying, what is the name of Denise's company? I wanted you to take over on that one.
It is the Kai's company, the Kai's family of companies. And yes, everybody calls us Keys, and it's okay. As our owner says, call us Keys, call us Kai's, doesn't matter, just call us. And there used to be a Ken Kai's. So there was a gentleman with that last name. We're currently on, I think, the fourth generation of Kai's. Mike and Tim Pappas are the most amazing broker owners that I've ever worked with. And now Mike's daughter and Tim's son are involved in the business, taking us to the next level of a company with all the support and technology that a millennial can bring to the table, because that's really where our industry is going. If you're not engaged in technology, you have to be, because that's where a lot of people are looking for homes on the internet. And then you have to embrace the technology that goes along with that.
Hey, Janky, let me switch gears for a second. We've been talking a lot about referrals and leads. let's talk specifically about relocation for a second.
Yes.
And I really want to ask Denise a couple questions. But when specifically for relocation, and I'm gonna promote Mooveguru for a second. The great thing about one of the programs that we do, which is connecting utilities, we do it across the country, coast to coast. So I know, Janky, you're right now, you're sitting in Sacramento, California. Denise and Mike are just outside of Fort Lauderdale. So you're total opposite ends of the country. Well, we cover everywhere. So when someone is moving, and let's say they're relocating to Ohio from South Florida, they don't know who their water company is. They don't know who their electric provider is. I mean, they're kind of like, they're lost. They have no idea what to do. That's where we step in and we say, hey, Mikey, we got you. And we got your customers. We're going to get on the phone with them and we're going to say, hey, yeah, you're moving to Akron, Ohio? Great. Here's your water company. We're going to get you connected. Here's your electric company. We're going to get you connected. Oh, you need internet? Great. There's three providers for that specific address in Akron, Ohio. Here's all their pricing, and we're going to get you connected. And we're going to do it all for free, all on behalf of Mikey. So when it comes to relocation, that's where Mooveguru shines. And hopefully, Denise and Mikey, you think that it's been a great service for your relocation customers.
Now, you're talking about local, right? So I'm now thinking, what do I do if I send a referral to Ohio? How do we help that person? So you and I will be chatting after this, Scott, because I think that there's other things to look at versus just our own agents using your program. So that's why I was saying at the beginning, it's a cliche, right? But think outside the box. What can you do different to be able to help your customers? And this is one of the things that actually may be a great thing.
Yeah. And I'm actually from the Bay Area, in Northern California. I'm from the Bay Area. I just came here for you know what reasons. But the thing is, and I don't want to jinx it, so let's hope and pray. But again, being from the Bay Area, we need this kind of service. And I know sometimes in our team structure, we try to implement, all these different utility companies to call them and, to send that information out. How awesome is it? Denise, tell us your experience with Mooveguru. And of course, Mikey, I'd love for you to share that as well. Like, how has your experience been? I mean, I'm sure it's awesome. That's why we're all here together. But tell us a little bit more about that experience.
So remember, I mean, you as agents are that first line of questions, like, oh my God, who would I call for this? Oh my God, who do I call
exactly.
for that?
Exactly.
So frankly, it does come off of the agent's plate, not totally, because you're still responsible for that relationship, right? It still comes off of the agent's plate, and really, they'll have all the information to be able to help that customer. I do have a question for Scott, though. How do you manage when they ask for social security numbers? Because that's probably important to talk about.
Yeah, absolutely. So when we're on the phone with one of Mikey's clients, and whether they're relocating or they're moving 2 miles down the street, we have a national database of who provides electric and gas and water, TV, phone, internet, and home security. And so we're going to tell the consumer, hey, here's everyone that provides you service to that specific address. Now, as we're going through, let's take a hard one. Let's take electric. Okay. Yeah. That's the one that usually wants to do a soft credit pull on your credit score. You're down there. So you're in Florida Power and Light territory. Janky, you're in the Bay Area. You're
PG&E.
Gas and electric. Yeah.
Right.
So what we're doing is we're actually working within their system. So we're working within FPNL system or within PG&E's system. Now, when it comes to the section where it says, hey, we need to do a soft credit pull, not a hard, a soft credit pull, that's not Mooveguru. That's actually Florida Power and Light.
Okay.
And most of the time, because someone's buying a home, they've got a good credit score, no problem, and they're probably not going to need a deposit. Now, let's say you're an agent and you're working with a renter and their credit score is, okay? It's not us collecting that $50 or $100 deposit. It's us putting it into Florida Power and Light system so that the deposit is there being held by Florida Power and Light. So all we are is the conduit between consumer, customer, and the power company. We're trying to mend the two and make a really hard scenario easy.
Wow. Perfect. We do have another question here actually from Amanda saying, do you share customer information with any third parties?
Ah, I love great that question.
Great question.
I love that question because the answer is no.
Never. Awesome. Yeah.
Okay. No. we never do. I love the question because as an agent, and I totally understand this, these are your customers. Mikey has worked his entire career creating a sphere of influence and creating a customer base that's taken him a lot of time and money to create. Okay.
Exactly.
We're never going to sell your customer data. We're never going to give your customer data to a third party. Other people do. We never, ever do.
Wow. That's just amazing. This, the entire company that you've created with Mooveguru and how Denise and Mikey are using it to its fullest level, and it's free. So where do agents go to sign up? I mean, we'll put it up on the chat here soon, but I mean, that's the first thing I want to know, because when I saw the YouTube video last night, I'm studying here with all these things and I'm like, Denise has got all this information for me. I need to know the case company and I need to know more about Mikey as well. So, when I was doing all my study and research last night, I'm like, okay, we need to know, how do we sign up? Where do we go? What else does our audience need to know about Mooveguru and of course case companies?
Okay, so Jenki, the first thing is since you're not a user of our free Mooveguru program yet, you're immediately gonna have to sign up when we get off. Okay.
Yes.
So and you're a huge high producing agent in the Bay Area yourself. So we'd love to support you.
Thank you.
LabCoatAgents in the chat box has dropped a couple links to a sign up form. And yes. Every time we do one of these webinars, thank goodness, we've got, 30 or 40 people that say, oh, geez, I want to know more. Great. So we'll get you on with one of our Mooveguru folks. We'll do a little 10 or 15 minute presentation for you. You're gonna ask us the questions because you're going to say, oh my gosh, you can't offer all this value for free. And the answer is yeah. We
kind of wow. Can.
And so please come and sign up. But Mikey, I want to hear some more from you. So how many of your customers are relocating in the South Florida versus how many are relocating outside of South Florida?
I would say, especially with today's circumstances, I would say we have a good amount of people coming from the Northeast into South Florida. We do have some that, are relocating, whether it's their profession that's taking them elsewhere. But I would say it's about, 70-30 at this point.
Gotcha.
Wow. We have a question from Nelia here. Is the client informed or permission given by them to share their contact info with Mooveguru?
Great question. Good question.
That is a really good
question. Great question, Nelia. I know Nelia.
Wow. In 4 years of doing this, I probably only had that asked of me a couple times. So great question. The answer is real simple. So because we're engaging with the consumer on your behalf, inside your state buyer's representation agreement or listing agreement, you have clauses in there that as long as a product or service is tied to the closing of that real estate transaction, that Mooveguru becomes an extension of that transaction.
So wow.
Right in your state agreement. So basically what happens is when Mikey has a customer and we're calling that customer up, we're saying, hey, we're calling on behalf of Mikey from Kai's. Mikey is giving you a complimentary service to connect utilities. It's part of the whole real estate transaction.
That is amazing.
Nelly is from Canada. Do you have business in Canada?
Oh my gosh, you're the second person today that has asked me that. That is weird.
I was going to ask on her behalf because I know that's where she's at.
look at us. We're making connections.
Engagement.
Right here on that. Yeah. Exactly. Connections, engagements, relationships within LabCoatAgents. I love it. I love it.
It's great. Okay, so the quick answer is not yet. The longer answer is you basically have three different, so you have about 47 different power companies in Canada, and you have three different providers for like internet and TV, and that's Bellus, Telus, Rogers. We have to reach out to all those companies and get relationships with them. What we're really looking for before we go into Canada full time is we're really looking for a partner in Canada that can help us take us in kind of in a really big level. So not yet, but soon.
Soon. Fingers crossed. Wonderful. Yeah, that's awesome. So Denise, I want to go circle right back to you. Tell us a little bit more about, you know, the KAIST companies. Not that, you know, the more we know, the better it is, about the relocation services, about the referrals, and you know, give us more information about that. I'm sure a lot of us would love to know.
So we do a lot of things out of our department. We have a local company that handles the local corporate business. So it's what I did 16 years ago when I came to KAIST, and then and I still do a little bit of it, but now that I manage the department, I do a little bit less of it. But going into local corporate companies to get them to use KAIST, not only for their relocation, but also setting up employee perks programs. So that's a way to generate activity through our agents. We are also, as a member of the Leading Real Estate Companies of the World Network, we also participate in their First Responders and Military Program. That is a program that really is, I mean, it's I love this program. It allows our agents to target our local heroes within their sphere of influence, whether they're in law enforcement, whether they're retired military, firefighters, and they give a small portion back as a rebate.
Wow.
We can do rebates in Florida, so they do a small portion back of the commission as a rebate at closing, and it engages them as well into doing more business. But I do want to start at step A, because what we're talking about is, I do blindly and I have a serious passion for it. But one of the questions that popped up is, how do you get the business? Don't forget ever, as busy as you get, that you still have to pick up the phone. You
yes.
still have to call 10 people a day. You still yeah. have to make sure that you're in touch with your sphere of influence. Just because they know or they see you on social media that you're in real estate, pick up the phone and talk to them. And yes. many forget to do that. And that is critical to starting growing your business. If you're not talking to people, don't just rely on email. Don't just rely on text. Do handwritten notes. I still, to this day, do handwritten notes. And that goes a long way, especially since a lot of people aren't doing that.
Yeah, we do happy birthday, birthday mail outs, handwritten.
How about anniversary cards out too? You know, the anniversary of their, you know, home closings. I think those are great, staying in touch with your clients. Go ahead, Denise. Sorry about that.
So referrals are important. Relocation's important. But remember that, networking locally, participating in your local chamber, that's all still very valuable, because that's where you're starting to build as a new agent, where you can start getting some of the business, right? And then if you come from other industries and you're new to the business, are you targeting your previous employer? Are you so don't forget that if you change careers, that's where your sphere is. That's where you should be working. So we basically develop programs and support our agents to get them to do that through all the tools that our company provides. Not an easy thing. But yeah, we always have to remind them to always pick up the phone and call 10 people a day. Just call 10 people a day.
I think that's my everyday morning call that I do to my agents as well, is that, you know, I want to know that this is what you're doing, no matter how long you've been in the business. I think that's a great point, Denise,
that
you've brought up. And, you know, having Mooveguru as part of your entire system that you have, you know, the system that KAIST has created, Mooveguru is, of course, part of your past and your sphere, you know, your past clients and your current clients that are closing, But how awesome is it to also continue adding, you know, the value that Mikey just said, you know, sending out birthday cards, anniversary yep. cards, you know, just a note card to say hello, you know, and calling 10 people a day. I think that is so important. And sometimes as realtors, we tend to forget because we're constantly working on our in our business.
Right.
Right, Mikey? I'm sure you yeah, can understand.
I like to say the relationship begins at the closing table.
Exactly. Exactly. Yes.
Just to add value, you know, and to build an ongoing relationship. And it doesn't always have to be real estate related. You know, you right. can add value personally, you know, so mm-hmm. you can, you know, a swimming coach, refer them a teacher, you know, be an asset to these individuals' lives.
And they can tell you care, right? They can tell you care when you do all this.
Yep.
Because that's what we're here for, is to help right. them, not only in the transaction, but also in their daily lives.
100%.
Absolutely.
Mike, what do you think, you know, you've built a big business. What would you say if you were to point out one thing, just one thing, what in your business, what is that one thing that you do that you might do a little bit differently than all the rest that has given you more business than anything else?
That's a good question, Scott. We really try and go above and beyond with these clients. You know, it's the service that we bring to the table. You know, we don't like to overpromise, but we like to over-deliver.
Over-deliver.
And it's just being consistent, you know, it's the work ethic and being consistent, you know, it's not just, you know, it's the 10 phone calls a day that Denise touched on. It's social media. We're huge on social media.
Yeah.
You know, we like to advertise our success, but more importantly, we like to advertise our clients' accomplishments, because that's what it's all about. We like to engage in our clients' social media. Because not only are we, you know, are they uploading our photos, but we have an opportunity in tapping into their networks, people we've never met before. So social media, if you're not on social media, you're at a huge disadvantage right now.
Agreed. Yep.
You know,
totally social media, agree.
It's like Mooveguru. It's free marketing. It's free.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You know,
so that it's one more time. How much does it cost?
Free! And you know, as realtors, anything that's a shiny object, a free or wine and cheese, you have realtors that are going to flock, and that's what we're known for. But it's okay because, you know, we want to pass that on to our clients and makes us look good. So when we say free, it's just, we love it, right, Mikey?
yeah. And for the realtors that are on here too, since I'm on social media, it's very important that your network and your followers get to know you on a personal level as well. Yeah. You want to switch up the content. You don't want to be so repetitive because it just gets kind of old and you don't get so many likes. So these people want to get to know you too. They want to know, hey, who's going to be representing my family? So my wife and I, we like to, every now and then, we have a 2-year-old running around the house. We have her swimming.
Adorable Emma.
But yeah, we have to switch it up. We like people to get to know us on a personal level as well, because they know exactly. We're selling houses, but they kind of want to get to know us too. So just a little tip there with social media content as well. We also do a lot of cross-marketing with businesses. We're very big into open houses. To give you an example, Scott, let's say we're doing an open house and we partner up with, let's say, the nearest pizza place. We'll have a bunch of pizzas at the open house where we're passing out flyers, and they're doing the same at their pizza shop. And it's a way to kind of develop a relationship amongst the community. And we do that often. So I'd love to get your logo and all this information when we're done, Scott, so you and I can definitely add to the arsenal.
That is awesome. That is an amazing tip you just gave them, Mikey.
Oh, yeah, you're welcome.
And I agree with Mikey. It's not all about professional, you know, and listings and things on social media. I have 4 dogs. I adopt seniors. So now aww. I'm down to 4. I was at 5 before the pandemic. So you'll always see dog pictures on my page. Yeah.
Wow, a little bit about personal.
It's important. It's important for, you know, our agents that are connected to me. It's important that they know what's important to me, and I know it's important to them. And we, you know, as large as we are, we're still a family. I mean, we really right. are. We know what's going on for the most part in, you know, agents' lives, and we stay connected. Well, that's not only do we do it because we want to, but then they project that on their own customers. So I think it's the environment and the family environment that we create that is bar none the best I've seen in the industry.
And I think it's so important to create, like Mikey said, the relationship. And how awesome is it when in that relationship you have Mooveguru coming in and you it's a free service to us as realtors, but we're giving back to our clients. So you're going to be the lifesaver at the end of the day for your client, because that's the most stressful time. It alleviates much of their stress.
Yeah.
Right. And another thing that you also said, Denise, which is, and even Mikey said this, is that, you know, on your personal page, you constantly talk about, don't constantly talk about business, because your clients want to get to know you on a personal level. Yeah. Those are fantastic tips. So that is just so amazing to know. But I think we should one more time share how to get in touch with Scott.
Yeah, sure. Thanks, Jakey. So, hey, Mikey, one thing I wanted to recommend to you is that within the Mooveguru program, you know, we've got all these national discounts that we deliver on your behalf to your customers, but we also do local discounts. So you just mentioned you have a local pizza place that during an open house, you get a bunch of pizzas, you have people come over to the open house. That pizza restaurant, if they want a free ad within the Mooveguru platform and the day of their move, you want your customers to get a discount. Say you go to the pizza place, you say, hey, offer my customers a 30% discount or a 40% discount, and we'll push it out to people on their move date, because 93% of people order pizza the day of their move.
Right.
Yep.
Wow. Okay. So now you get the local pizza place. And by the way, Mooveguru does not charge them to do this. We charge them $0, and they can do this. Now we can also do it for your plumber, for your painter, for your pest control company, for your landscaper. We don't charge any of these companies a dime. We just do it because we want to support Mikey and we want to support your customers and give them the best experience. So if you have vendors like that, let us know, because we'll get them involved. We'll even call them up on your behalf. Say, hey, Mikey told us to call you and give you a free pizza delivery email to a delivery. Excuse me. Yeah. I was thinking pizza. email to Mikey's customers. Just give them a discount. We're happy to do it. So anyway, just a little tip there.
We're networking again, live.
Exactly.
Networking live. It's amazing.
Right. And we just, look at this. Look what he just did. Again, glorified and really made Mikey look like the savior here. And that's what we like when, you know, realtors love that. Again, you know, love to be on that platform. And again, Mooveguru is doing such a fantastic job. Scott, we need to get in touch.
Yes,
ASAP.
And it looks like we have a question. From Court.
Court, right.
He wanted to know, probably everyone wants to know, Scott, you keep on professing free, 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 nothing's free. Well, So let's say you take Mikey's customers, and Mikey does a ton of business, right? So we're sending out emails looking like it's coming from Mikey's email address, branded to Mikey. And I'm sorry, what's your wife's name who's also on the brand?
She's Alessandra.
Alessandra. So from Mikey and Alessandra's email address, branded to them, branded to Kai's company, and we're sending out these discounts to help people save money during their move, okay? So let's say one of Mikey's customers walks into Home Depot and uses a 15% discount for a new refrigerator, and it just saved them $200. They're ecstatic, and they're calling up Mikey and saying, oh, Mikey, this is great, thank you, you know? Well, Home Depot is paying us a little tiny piece of that consumer spend. When someone uses a 20% discount on a budget truck rental pays us a little tiny piece of that.
That's great.
Spend. Well, when you add all those up, that's how we pay for the platform. We can make it free to the brokerage, free to the agent, and free to the consumer.
That's amazing.
Amazing.
Oh my God. Wow.
Very smart.
That is so smart. Exactly, Mikey. That is so smart. I mean, again, free to realtors. Realtors are looking great in this. Yeah, looking. And who wouldn't want to talk about you being the savior and, you know, coming through and referring you to their friends and family? You see, there's another stream of income. There's another stream of relationships that you're building through this process. That's fantastic. So
Denise? Denise, we have 2.5 minutes left. So I just want to ask you, first of all, I want to thank you. I want to thank Kai's company. I want to thank Mike. I want to thank Janky. And I'm going to give the last words to you, Denise, from Kai's. Do you have any final words of wisdom for us?
Before Denise goes and tells us a little bit more about Kai's, we have Joshua Murphy that just asked a question. I would like to know more about the platform to connect out-of-state realtors. I'm in, I think it's DFW area, that is exploding with new business development. I know we've had a lot of out-of-state people moving here, but not sure how to reach them. Don't have an answer here and now, but can you, one of you, contact me? And she has her email. Maybe we can, you know, help her with some advice. Maybe Denise, you might want to take this one.
If you can share her email with me, I'd
absolutely
be happy to catch up with her. Yeah.
Okay, sounds good. All right, we will do that. So Denise, yes, wrap up and tell us a little bit more.
This has been, I mean, great, great job, everyone. I mean, Mooveguru, amazing. Obviously, we don't have anything bad to say at all because they're just an amazing partner. Janky, great job hosting. Tess and the team as well. I think, you know, of all that we've said today, don't forget to take it back to basics. We're still doing this. We're still helping people's dreams come true. Whether they're selling and buying, just put the human aspect to it. And then, you know, as far as leads, connect with your realtors on the LabCo platform. I mean,
yes,
that is a huge source of leads,
yes,
there alone. So make sure you're active watch their policies, but make sure you're active in connecting with them because it does make a difference. You've got to be visible in generating your local business.
Absolutely.
And I think that's probably the what I can say.
Well, I want to definitely, yes, that's excellent, Denise. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And I want to say a few words before we go on to our daily days, work to do. But I want to thank, I really, really want to thank Denise, you know, for doing this for us at LabCode here. And we're big on helping, growing our agents, educating them and learning from each other. So fantastic tools that you shared with us, Denise. And Mikey, wow, you've shared some great tools. I've taken lots of notes. And, you know, as a top producer in Florida, in the Fort Lauderdale area, thank you for sharing some of the key points that we need to know and we learn from each other, right? Nobody is better than the other, but we're all better together, right? And of course, Mooveguru, you guys, Scott, you've created such an amazing platform. Like I said, I'm reaching out to you right after this because this is so awesome. You know, and thank you for sharing what you do for us here in the real estate industry. This is another arsenal in our tool bag. So thank you, each and every one of you guys. We here at LabCode Agents, we thrive on, you know, really growing and learning from each other. And what better way to do this than right here, right now, right?
Awesome.
Great.
Yeah. Thank you so much,
guys. It was great connecting.
Absolutely. And remember, everybody, to our audience out there, the replay is available on our YouTube at LabCode Agents. So, you know, please subscribe to our YouTube channel if you aren't already subscribed. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye.